Hey y'all, I got a quick tip for you CNC builders and CNC owners. This is a little troubleshooting aid that I'm gonna tell you about today. Everybody's heard or everybody's seen discussion about missing steps or missed steps. And basically an indication of that is lines aren't as long as they should be, squares come out rectangular, circles come out oval, things like that. It's basically one of the axes are not moving as far or as accurately as they should be. Well, I'm going to give you a little tip here that'll help you troubleshoot your problem without getting into software, getting into settings. It doesn't prevent missteps. It just helps you identify at a glance if there's a problem mechanically using nothing more than this. That's typewriter correction fluid, known here in the States as whiteout, known in the UK as Tipp-Ex. A little bottle of this will help you identify at a glance if you've got a loose coupler. So stick with me and I'll show you how I do it.
Well, this is basically simplicity itself. What you do is take the brush loaded with whiteout and draw a line straight up on the face of the coupler, then add a line onto the lead screw itself. Now, I had to re-dip the brush because I didn't have enough on there. Now, doing the motor end of the coupler is a little bit different. Some tight quarters in there, so I used a standard model paintbrush, dipped it into the whiteout bottle, and just drew my line on the motor shaft and right up on the face of the coupler there. That's it. Let it dry, and you're all set. And here are a couple of very bad stills. Sorry for the glare on the lead screw. But as you can see, those index marks will let you know immediately if either the coupler or the screw has moved, because they just won't line up.
So that's it. This little bottle can save you a lot of aggravation when it comes to troubleshooting, figuring out, has a coupler come loose? Now you have a way of knowing at a glance if a coupler came loose either on the lead screw or on the motor, and if so, which end. So it's not going to prevent a coupler coming loose. Again, it's just a way of identifying it at a glance. So if you want to make friends, influence people, or just, you know, make something sound more important than it actually is, these are called slippage marks. It's just a way for you to identify slippage. So, I hope it helps somebody out there. If you got anything at all from this video, give me a thumbs up down there. And until the next time, I'll just say thanks for watching and take care.